You know what I mean? So we need to make sure that we've got a right angle with 7 length here.
Okay.
So currently they're working on building a living wall to grow crops and indoors using a aquaponic or hydroponic system. And to maximize that vertical space and minimize the amount of ground that we need to grow those crops. But this is the first step in a larger, probably 8-week project in which the students are going to be building growth systems in our courtyard to grow crops for people with local people who have food insecurity.
Yeah, it's 1 inch by 6 and a half.
For this project, we had to use 1 piece of paper and 3 pieces of tape to hold rice in whatever we could. It could be a box, a cone, and in this case, a cylinder. But we couldn't use any more paper than what we had.
I was always pretty good at math, but I feel like if we can find a way to like implement it into the real world society, it wouldn't be as boring, you know, because if I know why I'm doing the math, then it's a lot easier for me to like say, okay, I'm gonna need this in the real world. So it's a lot easier for me to like pay attention. I know in the old math, I was always thinking like, what could I use this in real life for? Because it didn't really make any sense to me. So now it does, and I think that really helps with the education process.
We're really flipping a traditional classroom. We're in a traditional learning environment. Teachers might provide the content. Students will learn or memorize that content, and then they'll apply that content through maybe a test, an assessment, or a project. Where in this scenario, we're really flipping that classroom. We're providing them with a challenge or a problem that the students will have to work collaboratively to solve, and therefore apply the content that they'll learn. They'll ask the question, what content do I need to learn to be able to solve this challenge? And that will be provided through the instruction and provided through the learning environment.
Kind of like learning like in a way where it sticks with you instead of just like taking notes, taking tests, and it's like in the back of your brain but you're not really using it in real life situations. And then we're building so we know how to deal with it in real life situations.
Oh, wow, you guys got that.
We don't know what the jobs are going to be like when these kids graduate from college, but the skills that they're developing here are going to be applied to any field that they want to go to, whether it's engineering or not. They're thinking and they're doing, and it's incredible to see that.